Hi everyone, welcome back to Lucid Tutorials. In this video, I'll show you how to clean install macOS Ventura without using a USB installer or creating a partition on your Mac computer. A common way to perform a clean installation of macOS is to create a bootable USB installer, an external hard disk drive, or an SSD, which contains a macOS installer, and use one of these bootable external drives to install macOS on your MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, or iMac. The second method is to create a partition on your internal hard disk drive or SSD and install macOS on your Mac from the partition. The third method, which I will show you, doesn't require a USB installer or an external drive. You will only need a good internet connection. You may ask, do I have to perform a clean installation? The answer is no. However, a clean installation is a good way to upgrade your operating system. Many problems can be avoided during and after installation. Whether you want to do a clean install or upgrade from an older version, backup important files, data, photos, movies, contact numbers, etc. You will not regret it. You should upgrade your system on your day off or when you have lots of free time. There will be enough time to ask for help if something goes wrong. My current operating system is Monterey. I want to upgrade to macOS Ventura without using a USB installer, an external hard disk drive, SSD, or a partition on my internal disk. And as I mentioned earlier, I want to do a clean installation, so I will erase my internal SSD and install macOS 13.1 Ventura on my Intel Mac. I have already backed up my files in case the installation fails. Before erasing your disk, make sure you have the following items ready. Your user account password. This is the password you use to access your Mac computer. Network password. This is the password you use to access your Wi-Fi or wired network. Apple ID and password. This is your email address and the password you use to download apps from App Store and other Apple services such as iMessage, iCloud, FaceTime, etc. Also, ensure that your Mac is connected to the power outlet and disconnect all external devices except your mouse. There are two ways to use your internet connection to reinstall your current macOS or upgrade to the latest version. In this case, my current macOS is Monterey. If I press and hold down Command plus R after restarting my Mac, I will have the option of reinstalling macOS Monterey, which is my current OS, but if I want to upgrade to the latest OS, such as Ventura, I have to press and hold down Command plus Option plus R right after restarting my Mac. After your Mac restarts, you will have to choose your network from the drop-down menu and enter your network password. You will see a spinning globe and a progress bar. Next, you will see the Apple logo and a progress bar. You may have to wait around 10 minutes to get to the next screen, where you are presented with four options. Since I want to perform a clean installation, I select Disk Utility and click Continue. Once the Disk Utility has launched, click the View menu and select Show All Devices. If you don't select it, you won't see the Scheme menu in the next step. Make sure you select Show All Devices from the View menu. Now, select your Mac hard drive or SSD. Your drive icon is the first one in the left side column. Now click the Erase button and you will be taken to the following screen. Choose a name for your drive. You can name it whatever you want, such as Mac HD, Mac SSD, or Ventura. For the format type, you need to select macOS Extended Journal. For the scheme, choose the GUID partition map, which stands for Globally Unique Identifiers, and click Erase. It takes less than a minute to erase your hard disk drive or SSD. Finally, click Done. Now you can go to the Disk Utility menu in the top left corner of your screen and select Quit from the drop-down menu. Again, you may be presented with the macOS Utilities screen. Select Reinstall macOS Ventura. Click Continue and you will see the macOS Ventura installation screen. Click Continue. You may receive a warning that says an internet connection is required to install macOS. Click OK. Select your network name from the top right corner of your screen and enter your password. Again, you may see the macOS Utilities screen. Select Reinstall macOS Ventura and click Continue. When you click Agree, you will see your hard disk icon. Click Continue. Now it's time to drink a cup of coffee or wash the dishes. My MacBook screen went black for about 30 minutes during the installation. I got worried about it. I checked my Wi-Fi router and noticed the lights on the router were blinking fast. I realized that it was still in the middle of the downloading process. I sighed. After 10 minutes, the lights on the router stopped blinking fast. My MacBook restarted, the Apple logo and a progress bar appeared on the screen. I had 4 or 5 restarts during the installation, and the screen for selecting your country or region appeared. If you have made it so far, the difficult part is over. Congratulations. However, if you are new to the Mac operating system or need to learn how to set up your Mac, I have another video that takes you through the setup process step by step. I will leave the link to the tutorial in the description box under this video. I hope that this tutorial was helpful. If you learned something new from it, give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe to receive notifications of upcoming tutorials. Your support will encourage me to make more videos for you. Thank you for watching.